Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Today we have with us Mr. Thomas Franco, the former General Secretary of All India Bank Officers Confederation. We'll discuss with him today about the recent crisis in the Indian banking sector and the reasons for the mounting NPS. Welcome, sir. Sir, of late we are hearing a lot of news about the crisis in the Indian banks. From your perspective, what are the basic reasons behind these issues?
It is not true that banking sector is in any crisis. This is a man-made crisis. The Reserve Bank of India had been changing the norms for non-performing assets, and because of which they had a 360 days norms, then it became 180, then it became 90. Suddenly they said it will be one day now, because of which the number of NPAs and outstanding NPA has increased. A detailed analysis of this has been done by the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Finance and submitted to the government on 16th February 2016 itself, where they have analyzed the root cause for the NPA and they have also suggested what are the alternatives, what is to be done. Unfortunately, 3 years have gone, the government has not taken any action on that. For example, they have clearly analyzed that one major reason for the non-performing assets is the position of the economy. The economy is not growing. So when it is not growing, naturally it will affect on the banking sector. Similarly, they have said there has been inordinate delay in completion of projects. Another reason is the global meltdown. These are some of the reasons they have analyzed, and they have suggested as remedies few things. There are 16 recommendations, but some of the major ones I would like to touch upon. One is that they have said the developmental financial institutions, DFIs. We had ICICI, we had HDFC, we had IDBI. These were all converted into universal banks. They were created for long-term finance. So now the long-term finance was forced on the public sector. So they have suggested that you should revive the development financial institutions. That has not been done. Second, they had given a very easy and good solution. The outstanding NPA is large in the infrastructures. And infrastructure finance is supposed to be a long-term finance. Whereas banks collect deposits for 5 years, so they are not supposed to give long-term loans. Instead of that, they have been forced to. So what remedy they have suggested is that let the development financial institutions, like one of them which is still existing, the Industrial Finance Corporation, let it take over these loans. The bank's books become clean. That loan, let them convert it into a long-term finance. So the infrastructure which is being created, which is getting into a crisis, also can stand on its own. When the finance is converted into a long-term finance, 15 years, 20 years, they have a breathing time. And it takes time also for them to earn profit. So with the deferring of the repayment period, lengthening the period, they will start repaying, and those loans ultimately become the performing assets, and infrastructure will be helped, economy will be helped. These banks, once their books are clean, now they will start lending more, and that way it will give a boost to the economy. That has not been done. They have also said that you should take action on the managing directors and the board of directors who were responsible for the large corporate NPAs, especially in the case of defaults which have taken, which is called the quick mortality. But no action has been taken. They have suggested that Reserve Bank, which is having a controlling responsibility, should not ask their people to sit in the boards of the banks to take credit decisions. That has not been implemented. Similarly, Department of Financial Services, they have their representatives in the boards of the bank. They were party to the decision, so they should also be held accountable. None of this has been done. So because of that, the NPA is founding, and they brought in the schemes called the insolvency and bankruptcy code and National Company Law Tribunal, where more of write-offs are taking place in the name of haircuts rather than recovery. So it is a crisis created by the policies of the government. So the government has to take responsibility and alter the policies. That has not been done.
Speaking about NPAs, the mounting NPAs has always been a problem. The larger loans are very high, whereas the loans given to the farmers, small scale enterprises are very small. So what policy need, a policy change is needed to balance this particular issue?
See, from the day of starting up banks, there has been NPA. Bank knows, any lender will know that the entire loan will not come back. There can be many reasons for which somebody may die, somebody's business may collapse, there may be a calamity, so you will not be able to repay. So you always keep a provision for that. And we had been writing off loans, which was not creating a crisis to the bank's balance sheet, because earlier our loans were small loans. If you look at the data of Reserve Bank of India, 1990, most of the loans were small loans. 99% of the total number of loans were less than 2 lakh loans. So if 100 loan goes back bad also, that write-off is not going to affect your large balance sheet. But after 90, the government of India changed its focus. They changed the lending policy. They removed the MRTP Act, Monopolies and Restrictive Trade Practices Act. They removed the credit authorization scheme under which you had to take permission for giving any loan more than 1 crore. Many policy decisions were taken, because of which banks started lending more to the larger borrowers. Again, there was reduction in the bank staff. 10 years there was no recruitment. There was a VRS given called Golden Handshake, where in 1 year 1,34,000 people left the banks. So banks also found it difficult to cater to smaller borrowers. So the concentration of credit went to the corporates, large borrowers. If you see the last year's data, which is available in Reserve Bank, the number of loans as well as outstanding is much more with larger borrowers. There are around 14,000 borrowers who have taken loans more than 100 crores, who constitute total 38% of the total loans given. Just 14,000 people have cornered 38% of the total loans given in the entire banking sector. And RBI itself has given figures that the larger NPA is in the corporate sector. 86% of the total NPA belongs to the corporates. So unless you solve that problem, how can you solve the banking crisis of NPA? That effort is not being taken. So what I would suggest is that now they should change the policies, provide more staff, for have more branches, and encourage small loans. It is these farmers, it is these allied agriculture, small industries, cottage industries, artisans, who create local employment. And that employment is a major problem in the country. This can happen by redirecting the credit to the smaller borrowers.
So, but the government speaks volumes about making the day better for the common people, but whereas their policies continue to favor the corporates.
See, now they are doing a large exercise in the banking sector. Bank MDs and chairmen were called for a meeting for 2 days at Delhi, which was addressed by the finance minister as well as officials of the finance ministry, and 8 so-called experts were called to speak to them. Already, the former finance minister, who was just passed away, had been doing a review. Almost every 2 months, he used to review the progress of banks directly with the MDs and chairmen of the bank, which was very rare earlier. So if something has gone wrong, it is he and his ministry who are responsible for what has gone wrong. Now this exercise, what they are doing, they called 8 so-called experts. They call Uday Kotak, who is the managing director of Kotak Mahindra Bank, which is a small bank, which is in existence only for a few years, to tell the public sector bank, MDs and chairmen of public sector banks, what is to be done for the public sector bank's governance.
So they are indirectly saying that the public sector banks are so weak to get advice from a private banker.
And the funniest advice given by him is that he talks such nonsensical language. He says, now that 370 has been removed in Kashmir, now time has come for the government to act on the public sector banks. You have to privatize them. And he is giving an easy option. First of all, you do one thing. At least give 26% of the public sector bank's share to a private bank. So we become partner with this bank. And then we will improve the bank's governance. How many of the private sector banks are doing so robust? We have seen what is happening in ICICI. We have seen what has happened in Axis. So many other banks. And it is because of failures of many private sector banks that nationalization had to take place. So this is one example. Secondly, they call Nandan Nilkani, who had been heading Infosys, who had been heading UIDAI, that the solution here is digital. So you digitize everything, all problems will be solved. Without having a basic understanding that 26% of the population cannot read and write. And they also require banking. And you have opened Jandan accounts for them. Almost 90% of the people are not fluent with English. So what is your technology of digital banking going to help them? Number three, there are so many frauds taking place in the digital media. After the universal payment system, which UPI they started, there are so many frauds taking place when you link your Aadhaar card and the UPI. Somebody calls up and asks for your password, saying that we are calling from the bank, you share it. Within seconds, everything is gone and you don't know where it has gone. There is no way of tracing the money where it has gone.
So with this very bad security process, they are asking us to go digital.
And with that, he is saying that go digital, go digital. And you start charging for the services. Earlier ATM, anytime you can, any number of time you could withdraw. Now everything, there is a charge. You go to a post machine, there is a charge deducted. So, unless the people are comfortable for using technology, by forcing it, you cannot succeed. Even in developed countries like US, still now 50% of the people are using cash because they find it convenient. So this focus again is a wrong prescription for the public sector. Then Aditya Puri, which is the chairman of the HDFC bank, he comes and talks about retail lending. You increase your retail advance. Every bank knows that they would be comfortable by giving more loans to housing, more personal loans to salaried people, more loans to the farmers, because where the recovery is also sure. And it does not require a private bank's MD to come and tell the public sector bank what is retail lending. What is lagging there is that, see, retail lending requires larger number of workforce, larger number of branches. Rural branches, semi-urban branches have to increase. You are having business correspondents, 360,000 of them, who cannot take credit decisions. So what you require is a larger workforce. That you are not addressing. Salary and allowances is an issue for the bankers. 10 lakh employees are struggling for the last 2 years for a bank wage revision, which has not happened. So they are not happy. You are not addressing that. But you just force fellow people, if everybody is going to give only retail lending, what do you do with your huge quantity of deposit you are keeping. Who is going to serve the larger borrowers? That kind of a solution, as if the bankers who have worked for 30 years, 35 years in the banks, does not know anything. You bring in the so-called experts who do not really know what is a public sector bank, and you are giving solution. That is not going to work. Now, a large exercise, 150,000 bank branches, the branch managers were called in their own respective regions, and review meetings took place. A series of questions. If you look at the focus of the question itself, you know what is their intention. Why corporate loans have gone down? So that means you want the banks to once again lend more to the corporates without addressing the problem of the corporate NPA. Number two, why mudra loans are not picking up? Mudra loans are being given, large number of loans have been given to by the banking sector, where as per an award report, already 60% of the mudra loans have gone bad, they have become NPA.
But the government claims that mudra loans has been a great success as a policy decision.
They are claiming it as a success, only looking at the numbers. You should see whether it is really used for doing a business or running a factory, whether repayment is coming. Without looking at that, just by numbers saying that it's a huge success is not correct. And mudra loans are now getting totally politicized. The ruling party representatives, though they go with the loan application and they brought in some funny scheme called 59 minutes loan, where you were parting money with some unknown fellow who is going to give you only a provisional sanction letter. That does not make any sense at all. And in few days, one unknown company made crores of money by just making them download the application. And after that, you go to the bank. Bank has to follow all the norms. And that scheme is a total failure. And whereas government claims that it is a great success, you should look at the figures. And mudra loan, yes. The businessman, small industrialist, they require loan. But you have to create a conducive atmosphere for them. You brought in demonetization, you brought in GST, where still people have not understood for which, what percentage and how much is to be given. And every month you are supposed to file a return, which they are not capable. Small people, how they will be able to afford to do? All that has affected that sector. Now, just by asking to give some more loan, the solution is not going to come. Similarly, they are asking questions on NPA. Why NPA has increased? As if they don't know. As I told you, there are enough number of studies, reports available, including parliament report, analyzing the root cause of the problem. But now again, you are asking the employees to tell them. And now they are ranking the employees based on that performance. There is a huge fear that they are likely to send out some people saying that you are not performing up to the mark. Performance depends on many factors. Somebody in an interior area, in a rural area, his opportunity for performance might be much lesser. So performance cannot be just based on how many loans you have given. So that is again actually creating a fear psychosis among the employees. Then you have not created a correct mechanism for recovering the loans. They are asking questions about Startup India scheme, Swachh Bharat scheme. You create an atmosphere for that. Startups can succeed only if government provides adequate support to them. Now they have said that they are removing deferring the angel tax. That's a small portion. How much of the money for a new startup entrepreneur, how much comes from an angel investor? It's a very small amount. And for that, waiving tax, okay, fine. For a few years, you don't collect tax, it's fine. But that's not the solution. You look at the countries like China, which is, or Israel, where startups are being given lot of support, like Israel. Startup, you have an idea, the government gives the seed capital. In China, the banks are asked to support these startups, knowing fully well that at least 80% is likely to fail. But that failure, the blame will not be put on the bank. Instead, the government gives financial support to augment that shortage for the banks, because of which, without hesitation, banks, especially the development financial institution, they are giving loans. Here you don't create that atmosphere, but just force banks to lend more to the startups, that's not going to happen. Because finally, as a banker, when I decide on a credit, I have to look at whether the business venture is going to succeed, whether the money is going to come back. Once that guarantee is not there, I will not attempt to give that loan. Or just to satisfy the number, I will give a small loan and show that I have given so many loans, which will not really help the economy or the borrower.